Greetings and salutations, Dota fans. Welcome into this weekend playoff edition of the D2L Western Challenge. I'm EC, Trout beside me, and we're ready to get into the nitty-gritty. We're down to just a few teams, some fighting for survival now, as the lower bracket and the upper bracket have begun to take shape. We've got two best of threes on the way today. To lead things off, it'll be Empire, who made it in as our number two overall seed, taking on Fnatic, who upset Na'Vi just days ago. This is the upper bracket semifinals right now, so the winner will advance into the upper bracket finals and, of course, have a chance to make it into the grand finals as our upper bracket participant. Let's take a look at how these two teams match up. We've yet to see Empire in action here in the playoffs. In fact, it's been a while since we've seen Empire in action in the D2L just because they burnt through their early group stages. Empire, of course, a very strong contender in every tournament they enter and a favorite to perform in pretty much every single LAN you ever happen to catch them on. Fnatic, of course, the team up. Yeah, there we go. Wanted to make sure we got that up. So, Empire, we'll focus on them for a moment. As they said, they made it in second out of the group stage, finishing up 5-2 with 9 points overall. They're led by Mag out in the off lane, who has really carved out himself a good reputation for being one of the most versatile and one of the most stable offlaners in the game today, especially out of the West. Silent, of course, in mid, a fantasy star if ever there was one, as well as Resolution. Resolution really has been one of my personal favorite players to watch. Over the last few months, he really does a phenomenal job out of mid, a big tempo controller in his own right, extremely good on a number of heroes such as Invoker and so on, who really can set the pace of the game. They've got Vanscore on support and always want to fly, playing on the 5 position. On the other side of the river today, again, they'll be matching up against Fnatic. They're going to be playing down a man, but, you know, even though Era's not going to be with us again, he is still battling some health issues, so make sure you tweet some love to him and wish him a get well soon kind of a message. He is being replaced by a player who is really building a hell of a fan base and has shown time and time again that he is more than capable of competing at this level, and not just competing, but showing dominance in a number of different ways. That will, of course, be Excalibur, who is standing in again for him today and had an unbelievable series against Na'Vi earlier in our playoff picture. Fly is the leader. He's on the hard support. They've got Hani, of course, in mid. No-Tail, a fan favorite, Big Daddy, who also had a standout day the last time we saw him in action. He'll be looking to repeat that success now with Trixie in the offlane. As I mentioned, I'm your host, Aaron A.C. Chambers. I'll be bringing you play-by-play and direct commentary, but to break down and give the insight and analysis, this will be Trout, right back here in the beautiful mothership in the headquarters of Kingston HyperX. This is the HyperX D2L, so we wanted to come down, bring our entire rig down here, and show you guys everything that they've been doing, they've been building out. This is in the middle of their office. This is their LAN center. I don't think we've gotten a technical term for it. I'm going to call it the eSport. It's like the Beast Conference Room.
The Beast Room. I love that term. It's a really cool term.
But they have built this to show their dedication to eSports in general. They have a lot of teams come through. Teams that need a place to boot camp. Just teams that they want to liaison with. And it's really been a pleasure to be down here over the last couple of days. And we still got a few days ahead of us, you know, leading up to Tuesday, our grand final. A
lot of gaming to be had here for both of us after the cast. So, yeah, the computers are nice, everything. There's so much room, too, so it's nice as a player coming in here.
Oh, yeah.
You know, sometimes you come to set up from setup to setup, and things don't feel right, but it's there's a lot of room for these computers.
Well, their staff has been in. Like, their staff comes in and checks on us. Must be 24 times a day. Just, you know, is the equipment working? Is there anything you guys need?
Very helpful.
Like, and what I think is awesome is not only do they come in and do that, they come in and watch the games. Like, you know, working in esports, you know, you work with people. Sometimes they know the game, sometimes they don't. Sometimes they really love competitive gaming. Sometimes they just really love the industry. These are people who just love to come in and hang out and talk about esports in general, especially Dota 2. So really has been a big treat for us. We're going to jump on into the draft very, very quickly as we are more than halfway done now. 3 picks deep for Fnatic, while Empire has led off with 2 as well. Empire grabbing up the IO, first chance they got, and the gyrocopter, and they've done their homework, banning out Tinker and Meepo. And what an awesome experience it must be for Excalibur, who is a stand-in that everyone was curious about. They felt like Fnatic was going to be weak, missing Era, because Era is a phenomenal carry in and of itself. But now you have teams like Empire that are respect-banning your two heroes as a stand-in.
Yeah, that's what I was talking about yesterday. It really says a lot to you personally. Like, you're coming in as a stand-in, and you're getting respect banned. And sometimes it's just like, oh, it's funny that they actually did that. But you do see the success of it. Like, you've actually watched him do this, completely carry games with these two heroes by himself. But then again, you know, we saw yesterday actually where Fnatic would just picked a Wisp Tiny right off the bat, and he just went ham on Tiny too. So I don't think it's necessarily I can only play these heroes. I just think he's actually legit, and he can. And he knows what he's doing just in general, not just on those heroes. But speaking of Wisp, by the way, picked up very early on here for Team Empire as they pick it with a gyrocopter. And then Fnatic has Doom, Earthshaker, and then a Skywrath Mage. So kind of interesting picks right there. I'm not surprised one bit with the Doom pick.
No.
Especially with Fnatic. They picked it up early on yesterday, I believe, too. And it's just been a powerhouse, and for good reason. We've talked to great length about just how good he is.
Mm-hmm. Well, Doom and Skywrath, and what we're beginning to see, even to an extent with Silencer, like, and some teams prefer a different style to others, but we're beginning to see teams really prioritize the idea of long-duration silences, or at least strategic silences, like Skywrath Mage with the seal, Doom, of course, with his ultimate. Silencer has been seeing more and more play, and you know, Silencer is one of those heroes that I've just always expected to be a little more popular than he is, but you don't see it all that often. So far, we don't see, we're not going to see him in this game, but he has been banned by Empire. Do you think he's finally surging to the point and getting that popularity? I mean, he is so strong when used correctly, and the thing is, we saw him used in two different ways by Fnatic last time they played. We saw a little bit of up-and-down performance on, I want to say, was it Hani that was playing it, or was it Trixie?
Trixie.
Yeah, okay, it was Trixie. It's not that he played terrible, but the timing of the silences was just really hit and miss. Then we saw No-Tail get it the next game, and it was on point, and it just felt like there was nothing Na'Vi could do about it.
I don't know. I don't want to say anything, but I'll just say that No-Tail played it better.
Don't want to flame. I understand. Fnatic grabs the Kunkka, by the way, so they're one pick away from completing their lineup. And Empire grabbing up Clockwork. And, you know, I love lineups like this. I mean, you have an Io and a Gyro, which is very strong in and of its own right. Now you've got the long range, that initiation reach of clock.
I love Kunkka.
They're going, Kunkka is another one of those heroes that I've always just kind of expected to be a little more popular than he is. He has his weaknesses, don't get me wrong. Fact of the matter is, he can throw a boat every 60 seconds starting at level 6, dude. That's kind of ridiculous.
Actually, it's 40 seconds
but I'm saying at level 6, he can throw it every 60.
Right.
So the moment, like, if you send him mid, by the time you're 5 minutes into the game, you have a boat every 60 seconds. That's kind of nuts.
It is. And the damage actually is really high, too. Like, it's such a good spell, everything about it. And I just think he's also actually very good in mid. Like, he can go against a lot of different heroes. If you pick a hero to try to counter him, or pick a hero from mid that's ridiculously strong, like OD, he actually does quite well just because he has the extra damage from the Tidebringer.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I'm a big fan of Kunkka. I think he's very, very strong. I was going to mention one thing. Oh, so you're talking about the resurgence, or I guess just the how Silencer has kind of come into the scene. I think maybe a little bit of that, too, is not too long ago he got the Ags upgrade to the Curse of Silent, being applicable with the Ags upgrade. And, you know, maybe that has something to do with it, too, because it actually is quite good when you get Ags and then Refresher. So the cool thing about it is, like, not only does it apply, but because you're silenced, you actually can't cast a spell to dispel it. So it's actually kind of a cool little interaction
We saw that actually have a big effect. It was against the Tidehunter. We saw a silencer that would cast his ult even before Refresher came out. Whenever you're talking about, say, a 4 or 5 position Tidehunter, it doesn't matter. I mean, yes, you can have Arc Boots, and that helps to an extent, but how many times in that game, I can't remember who it was, it might have been Fnatic versus Na'Vi. Like, honestly, they start to run together after a while. But how many times would we see the silence run off and a Tide just wandering around hoping to ravage but had no mana to do so?
Yeah, exactly. I mean, it's actually a little bit I can't even say underrated because it's being picked more and more, but it does, like, it's 14 seconds when you have Ags, you know, plus level 16 with a Refresher. 14 seconds of Curse of the Silent that you cannot dispel unless, of course, you have a BKB. But most of the time, it's the support heroes that suffer from this, and there's the ones that are casting the spells that you need in the fights anyway.
Exactly.
So, yeah, it's actually pretty, pretty legit.
All right, so the lineups are done. Last pick, Shadow Fiend for Fnatic and Empire, shoring things up with another support in the Treant Protector. It'll be Excalibur playing on that Shadow Fiend, and looking forward to this. This is actually going to be an action-packed game. And once again, Hani's going to be on the Earthshaker. Usually, whenever up until the last few days anyway, whenever we had casted Fnatic throughout the group stage, they almost always had No-Tail on that Earthshaker. But Hani was phenomenal on it the last time we saw him use it against Na'Vi. So no big surprise there. It'll be Fly on the Skywrath, so it will be a support Skywrath Mage. On the side of Empire, offlane for Mag. Silent, of course, will be farming up the Gyro. Resolution will be looking to take the DK mid.
Yep. To build more on your point about resolution, as you're talking about him in the pregame, I'm really impressed with him. And I didn't know much about him before we really started casting D2L. I knew he was a good mid player for Empire, but I've been watching him, and he knows his stuff. Like, he knows exactly how to play that lane. Mm-hmm. And so it's just actually very, very fun to watch him. He knows exactly what he's doing. He always gets very high CS against whatever hero he's playing against. In this case, well, we have Excalibur on Shadow Fiend, but he's usually one position replacing Era for the time being. They can go safe lane farm with him. It's just kind of, it's not the thing you normally expect. But to build more on your point, too, with Hani playing the Earthshaker, I've known Hani and Kai for a long time, and he's loved Earthshaker for a long time. Like, it's really one of his favorite heroes.
Right.
And he plays it quite well, obviously. So it's going to be fun to see him do it again. And Big Daddy on the Kunkka, by the way. Is this a support Kunkka?
Wow. That would be interesting. I don't know. Like, one thing that I think makes Fnatic such a dynamic team, and again, don't get me wrong, I'm not trying to argue they're better without Era. I mean, Era's, for a while, been one of my best friends in the scene and one of the most awesome guys you'll ever meet.
Oh, he's super nice.
If you get a chance to meet him in a LAN, walk up to him and shake his hand. He'll probably hug you just out of sheer happiness. He's got just one of those guys who just exudes that. He's phenomenal. Mm-hmm. Has always been a top-tier carry. But one thing that, if there is a benefit to sliding in Excalibur, is we see Fnatic really switch around roles a little bit more now. You're beginning to see No-Tail do a little do things a little differently. Like you said, it will be the Big Daddy. He is starting out. Yeah, he actually started out.
He has a TP. He bought a TP.
I just saw that too.
So maybe they're trying to guess some lanes, and if they get it wrong, they want to rotate quickly.
Immediately.
That's the only way I would see him wanting to buy a TP. So yeah, interesting stuff. But I mean, yeah, no, I agree. I think it's actually very beneficial if teams can play, if players on teams can play different roles just right off the get-go, because not only does it confuse the other team, but it makes you ready, and it really increases your draft pool.
Oh yeah,
like, and you can pick so many different heroes.
Well, like you said, the draft pool is one thing, but whenever you have whenever you have a team composed of players that are just known, and you know, Alliance is a good example of this. Everyone on Alliance has like a top tier one or two heroes where they're just one of the best in the world, hands down, no doubt. You know, when you talk about what S4 can do in mid, when you talk about of course Admiral Bulldog and so on, when you have a team like Fnatic and you're beginning to run them the way that they have been lately, you see, you know, say a pick like a Skywrath, or you see a Shadow Fiend, suddenly you're not sure where that hero's going to end up, because he literally could end up anywhere, just because they're really pushing the idea of changing things up and trying to outthink you, trying to be a little more subtle and a little bit more sneaky in the draft, and it makes it tough to draft against. So the horn's going to blow, though, and this is game one of our leadoff best of three of the day. This is our upper bracket semifinal match, the first one to come out in the playoffs so far. Winner of this advances to the upper bracket finals. Empire making their debut in the playoffs against Fnatic, who, of course, got past Na'Vi the last time they met. So taking a look at the lanes here, it's going to be Vanscore, always want to fly. He's hanging around the offlane right now. We'll be silent on the gyro. We'll see if they're going to go ahead and rotate. But, yeah, it looks like, they're just going to go ahead and walk through the jungle. In mid, the matchup will be Resolution, playing on the DK with Excalibur, handling that Shadow Fiend mid. Hani is on the Earthshaker right now, making his way towards mid. Trixie, of course, on the Doom, and then Mag out in the off lane. And based on what we see so far, what do you make of the lanes? Oh, hang on.
Oh, it's a possible action on a Shadow Fiend. That's a nice block there, Hani.
Knew it was coming.
With some decent game sense here.
Yep.
He rotated
just as that was coming.
Yeah, Excalibur, who, by the way, doesn't have his souls first, so he went for the Shadow Race to get that quick bottle.
Yep.
So, as far as the lanes, I was too busy laughing to myself about Resolution, and I know it's kind of a small deal, but he's blocking his creeps, which is a big deal in mid, and he's at the same time saying, good luck, have fun, in all chat. I know it's kind of a small thing, but I think it's really funny, because normally you just want to be very, very focused about getting that block correctly, but he's so comfortable with it that it's not a big deal. But
they're going to engage. Vanscore caught from behind, misses with the torrent. Hani trying to catch up with him, had a fissure, but decided to hang on to it. Probably the right call. Not really any chance for them to get up there. But like you said, taking a look at who's farming right now, does appear that it's actually Fly and Big Daddy both that are kind of splitting the CS. They've got one apiece.
Yeah, interesting stuff, but I don't think that they can win this tri-lane at all.
No,
like, it's very difficult, at least early on. Gyro is getting complete free farm right now at this point. And this is a little bit different than, you know, when we saw Roxas aggressive tri-lane. I think it's very important for two things in your aggressive tri-lane. One, you pressure them, and you have to pressure that tower. I think that's the biggest thing, but on top of all that, as we have a pause come out, you can't miss CS. You can't forget that, okay, yeah, I'm aggressive. I need to be in their face and, you know, make them kind of be pushed back and stuff. But you still need to get all your CS. You need to act as if you're the one. I mean, he is the one. So he needs to constantly get the CS. Right now we have 11-3 for Silent. So he's doing a good job.
It looks like Vanscore having a bit of lag. Should not be the case because we are playing every match on Lux this time around. Every team, including Evil Geniuses, is actually in Europe. So that's actually a nice little benefit with the timing of the Western Challenge. And I want to take a moment to go ahead and thank each and every one of you for tuning in with us here today and days previous. And, of course, looking ahead to those who will tune in the future. It's actually been a pretty big success. We had a big day yesterday. And, you know, it's one of those things that quietly happens, you know. D2L events, we try to run them as many as often as we can, and we have very good viewership for the most part in comparison to pretty much anyone you want to compare us to. But then we have days like yesterday where we came very close to cracking 60K for just a regular old, you know, opening, like quarterfinal, upper bracket quarterfinal match. So it ended up really working out well. And that's, of course, thanks to you guys. And we get to continue running these D2L events all because of your support. And don't want to forget the fine folks in-game as well who bought a ticket. And this year, we honestly didn't have an item. And there's still plenty of you who just love Dota enough that didn't need an item and bought a ticket to support the tournament. And that means the world to us. All right, we're back underway. And we'll see if these lanes are going to bear fruit for Fnatic. This is definitely something I think they're going to have to try to change up soon because Empire is just in a great position thus far.
Well, Excalibur's actually doing very well mid. Like, he's actually beating DK quite... Oh, a career kill.
Where did
Dire's that... career, as Vanscore with the snipe comes around. He's behind the creeps now. He could be in some trouble. He needs to tether. He needs to tether partner. He does find Resolution. Resolution too close to the cliff, though, so... But he will be okay. Oh. No!
Yep,
nice block there
ground.
From Hani. Can Excalibur get there in time? It's a long-duration Fissure, as it was buffed not too long ago.
Oh,
Vanscore... I think he should be okay. So nice courier snipe. It is successful, and he gets out alive.
Yep. And saw him drifting through. I actually just thought he was going to try to make something happen mid, but instead sniping the courier, and that actually is kind of a big deal. Taking the Shadow Fiend does have his bottle, so it wasn't. He didn't lose his bottle.
It's not the end of the world.
Right, but it's rather inconveniently, and suddenly rune control matters a little bit more.
I actually wonder, okay, Hani's going back to base because he needs to regen. I wonder if he's just going to pick up Excalibur's boots for him that he has in the stash and just deliver them to him, be the walking courier. So I'm serious. Like, I bet he's going to. Maybe Excalibur drops the boots. I'm waiting to see, but, you know, not having a courier early on at this stage of the game is actually, it feels like an eternity. I don't know if you've ever had this happen to you, but it actually does feel like forever.
Oh, man, like, I usually play support, but when I do play mid, if it ever happens, like you said, it's a nightmare.
Yeah.
Up at top, though, Big Daddy and Fly continuing to be shoved around pretty badly. It looks like No-Tail has taken over primary farming duty, but he's only up to 6 CS at this point. Hani is not the courier, but would have been cute if he was. He did not pick anything up. He is going to make his way up the top and try to relieve some of this pressure on the duo lane. Tower is under
attack. Yep. I'm actually... Doom is not doing too badly down here. Oh, action possibly on Always Want to Fly. There comes the concussive shot. Big Daddy faking it out with the torrent as he's not going to go for it. He's on level 2, though. He's actually very, very low level. Silence level 4.5. So, yeah. Even if he does hit the torrent, that's just like very minimal damage at this point.
Yep.
So, yeah. They're definitely getting crushed in this top lane. Doom not doing too badly, as I mentioned that. Pretty much even with the Clockwork, but I think Clockwork has a little bit of an edge.
Yep.
It kind of depends. But, oh, Trixie, he got the nice crit creep. I didn't see when he really rotated to the jungle to get it, but that actually is really big in lane when you're 1v1. So he's actually hitting like a truck. He's hitting for basically 100 damage with chance to crit as well. So that actually changes a lot of the dynamic between this 1v1.
Which hero do you think benefits the most from having a like you said, it's basically a wash in terms of CS and all that. Which one do you think benefits the most out of that laning situation? Which one do you think is it's much more important that they're getting up? Hang on. Fly. Oh, Fissure actually did not trap him. Here comes Vanscore in, and the torrent was off the mark. So No-Tail having some trouble connecting on the torrents thus far. Always Want to Fly, takes some damage, but manages to make it away and salve himself up quite easily. So Fnatic having a little bit of trouble making this lineup work in an aggressive sense. But coming back down here, what do you think it's more important to have this kind of level of farm and experience gain? It will be the Doom or the Clock?
Oh, the Doom, for sure. But that this is just the beauty of the hero, man. Like, we talk about this all the time, but it's so hard not to when it gets picked up, is that even if he doesn't do well, he's still going to do well eventually just because of Devour. It's so good. But the fact that he is doing well just makes it that much worse. I'm still curious why people go more into Scorched Earth than Devour.
Excalibur. In some trouble in mid. Yeah, there's first blood.
Nicely
Resolution.
Played.
Resolution just whittled him down using his poison dragon breath and then caught him with a dragon tail and finished him off. Big Daddy being pursued into the jungle, makes it away into the trees just north of his tower. And yeah, it's about time they abandoned this tier one. Fnatic obviously losing this laning phase pretty badly at this stage. What do you think they need to do to change up the status quo?
I would say smoke and gank bottom. Like, they're actually doing quite well. And because Trixie is beating Clock, in terms of both CS and just dominance, like I would say focus on him because he's not going to be able to leave. Like, he needs to kind of stay in this area. I guess he could TP mid and try to go for a gank on the Shadow Fiend again. I don't really mean again in the sense that he's gone there once before, but he's already died once because he's not really accomplishing anything down here. So, you know, he's down there. I would say Fnatic smoke gank and just go kill Mag bottom.
Unfortunately, it looks like with the double damage rune picked up by Resolution, he has Elder Dragon form in 4 seconds. Trixie's going to be in some trouble. Caught by the Dragon Tail and eating a bit of damage. There's the hook. Mag level 6. And in the meantime, there's action in the jungle as well. They're going to be able to bring down Trixie. Let's see how this breaks out. Big Daddy has him hemmed up. Gyro could be in trouble. Vanspore right there with him, just level 3. But the damage output just isn't there for them. They're too underleveled, and now Empire on the charge. There's the Skywrath down. They're going to end up losing No-Tail when all's said and done. One last auto attack will do it. And this is an unmitigated disaster of a laning phase. There is nothing going their way now on this map. Resolution with his rotation securing the kill on Trixie. And of course there, after the tier 1 drops, another set of kills for Empire in top lane. They have got to do something. Otherwise, this is going to run away from them before they ever even get a chance to get their legs underneath them.
I mean, yeah, they have to do something. But look at what their lanes were. Like, their only really real winning lane was kind of... Well, I guess they kind of won bottom, too.
Yep.
Mid was basically even until... If you get a solo killed by a player without rotations, it's really, really bad. Like, it's really bad. You get solo experience on the mid hero, the one that's already getting the most experience anyway. It's on a DK who just takes that farm and experience and runs with it, ganked bottom afterwards. So Resolution is playing very, very well. But what the hell do you expect to have happen in that tri-lane top for Fnatic? Like, that's just a wonky tri-lane.
Really is. And there's going to be an X-Torrent. Damage is there that time. So they finally get a free one as Hani and Excalibur are there to help out and finish things off. Fnatic makes it onto the board finally, but they're going to need a lot more than that. Take a look at the goal graph. 4K is the current lead generated by Empire at just 8 minutes in. So at 8 minutes in, this early in the laning phase, 500 gold per minute lead generated is the mark they're on. We're going to see Silent hook up with Vanscore, and yeah, never mind. I was curious who's going to go try and fight instead, just looking for creeps to farm. Resolution finds another rune in the meantime. That'll be an invis. Midas now done as well, but that'll be on Fnatic. So hopefully that'll give them a little bit of a chance to bring things to bear. If they can keep him alive and using that Midas, they'll be all right.
Yeah, I was thinking actually maybe Trixie should go for Midas too this game. Oh. Doom up on the mag. Can they catch him? There's a concussive shot, but there's a living armor as well to keep him alive for the time being. Treant coming in. Can he get the Leech Seed to save him in time? I don't know. It's going to be close. I think he might fall.
Yep.
It's going to be very close. Yeah, one more auto attack. He should be dead. There's the nuke there from Skywrath. No ulti there from Treant because he's only level 4. So nice gank there.
Resolution using his invis. Looks like he was pecking away this tower. Oh, he got it. So cheeky. And a little bit of mistiming on the auto attacks there. No-Tail being zoned out once again from his tower at top. Tier 2, not keeping him safe. We're going to see Fnatic converge now. And they better get out of here. There's going to be an X. Torrent on the mark. Call down is there, but Silent overstaying is welcome and paying the price. You can't do that.
What the hell is he doing?
Yeah.
Like, there's absolutely no reason for him to be up that far. Like, there's no reason. Like, they're not going to kill someone. There's only him and Wisp.
Right.
They're not going to push the tower. And they just saw the heroes rotating from mid. There was no one showing bot. That's just silly. That's a silly
just
play.
Just silly.
Yeah.
Just silly.
Silly play.
Too much pub mentality, I think. That's the kind of thing you can get away with in pubs whenever you don't have teammates that are going to rotate appropriately. But Fnatic, a little bit above that in terms of skill ceiling. They're going to converge on you if you get that far out of position. So Fnatic has cut down the kill gap a little bit, 4-3. But unfortunately, the efficiency of Empire is continuing to roll right about the same speed and where it was before. Mag's over behind the tier 1 now. Fnatic has 3. But he's going to hook right on top of Trixie. He's going to end up hitting the Skywrath. That might have bitten off a bit more than he could chew. There's a nice fissure to block him out, so what should have been a free tower is going to end up being a trade at least for one hero. Leech Seed a little late from Always Want to Fly. Not enough to heal the clockwork up. But Silent, in the meantime, just continues to farm up. He's already got up his phase treads Aquile, so a very stable build out of him. And we'll see if he wants to go Ultra Greed, go something like at Helm of the Dominator next, or if he's actually just going to go for damage. He's going to go ahead and crest the stairs, heading up towards the Dire Secret Shop. And throwing the call down. Here's Excalibur, though. That ulti on the mark. Doesn't do a ton of damage. Boats off the mark, too. And Empire. There
resolution.
We go. Yep, resolution showing up. I was going to say, Empire just needed to pick a target. And finally, they did. Able to clean up the Doom. And this is unfortunate. There's going to be an X on the Silent. He's going to be brought back into the Torrent. But the damage is just so lacking in every phase right now. Wow, he caught up with Excalibur through the trees. That's a big kill in and of itself. And I don't know what Fnatic can do. They're just getting run over every time there's a big team fight.
I really feel like Resolution like carries this. Like he knows exactly his limits. I love his builds too. Like right now, he's got a friggin' Shadowblade completed on top of Treads, a casual Ogre Club for the time being at sub 12 minutes. Man, this is so good. Won his lane with rotations from Urshaker coming around to save possible ganks coming into the Shadow Fiend. Rotated bottom, push a tower mid, push a tower bottom. It just pursued the issue on the Shadow Fiend there yet again. It's going to be easier now that he has the Shadow Blade to close the gap. Just fantastic play from Resolution. And I see him play Dragonite all the time, which is a hero that I think requires a lot of skill.
A lot of decision making. That's a thing. And I agree with you. I think Resolution is kind of a hybridization of some of our favorite mid heroes. Like when he's on an Invoker, he's just as good as anyone. He plays Exhort.
Think he's like one of the best.
Oh, by far. Oh, definitely.
He's very good.
He has that patience and decision making of a more passive mid. You know, like that's one of the things that makes like S4 so good at what he does. His decision making, for the most part, he's a great player. His skill is off the charts. But really, what defines him is his ability to assess a situation, make a decision, and have an impact. And I feel like Resolution has a lot of that. And he also has the skill ceiling, kind of the tempo control. Of a player like a Dindi. Like, he's just so good at what he does. Now we're going to see Excalibur spotting out Always Want to Fly. Rest of Fnatic is there. Call down and connect. And, yeah, they're just going to go for it. There's a Doom on the Silent, and this could be the chance for them to turn it around. But Resolution, doing good damage from behind, manages to go one for one, trading away with the Shadow Fiend. Silent is still there. There's going to be a good fissure to hit Mag and Silent both. Silent's still doomed for the time being. And he's going to be hit with an X-Torrent and an Echo Slam as well today. And, yeah, they just got their Courier, too. So Empire losing their first major team fight of the game.
Five-man wipe. I mean, Trian just respawned, but that's a five-man wipe.
Yep, and no, that's a five-man plus a courier down, man. Everything they controlled on the map at that moment died. Every single unit they could possibly control died at least once. And that's a shot in the arm for Fnatic and exactly what they needed. It was getting to the point of critical mass. Now, though, by the time this ends up updating fully, they're going to end up having probably cut down the lead of Empire by about half.
Experience is actually in favor now for Fnatic.
Is it?
Yeah.
Wow.
It's about 1,000. No, 2,000 and rising.
Wow.
Yeah, pretty crazy. I just did not expect that to happen, that I didn't even really see the beginning of it. I just saw Resolution in a very precarious position without BKB, and then he got focused. It was actually kind of a misplay by Excalibur. He did not need to die.
Yeah.
It should have been a 5-0, honestly, but Excalibur got really, really greedy. Went back in for an auto attack or two onto the Dragon Knight and died as a result. But nonetheless, a fantastic exchange for Fnatic. They'll take that any day of the week.
Oh, yeah. And they did. They cut it down from approximately 7,500 to right around 3,000. So they have really put a dent in that gold lead. And we'll switch on over to net worth and see where they stand. Excalibur is right on the cusp, but as of right now, both Silent and, of course, Resolution sitting atop the overall net worth. But, that basically just reset this game almost entirely.
Put them back into it, I would say. But they're still down a lot of towers, and they have none themselves. So as far as map control goes, they're very lacking. It's very difficult to actually get as much farm as the other team when you're down these many towers just because their lanes are always pushed. They have easier access to your jungle. So, yeah, in that sense, I would say that they're back in this. Before, it was, really, really bad.
Yeah.
Doom, he didn't go for the Midas. Not the greedy build we're going to see from him. He's going for phase and probably just a BKB. So just the core stuff.
And speaking of BKBs, I think that's when things are going to get really problematic for Fnatic.
Problematic for Fnatic.
You know it, man. Poet didn't know it. When Resolution gets his BKB up, where's the damage from Fnatic going to come from? I mean, they're getting a bit of right click out of the Shadow Fiend right now.
Shadow Fiend, yeah.
But it's not enough. He, you know, we've seen how tanky and how far ahead he is. Most, I mean, do they? I think they have to end up dooming him and ignoring the gyro. But the gyro's not doing in bad shape either. I mean, he's going to have a BKB up soon. So you lose Shadow Rage, you lose Skywrath Mage, his entire kit becomes worthless. The Earthshaker, yeah, I mean, a fissure is a fissure, but still, it's not nearly what you want it to be. And Kunkka is a support Kunkka. So, I mean, well, kind of. I mean, he feels like a support Kunkka, but he's kind of been farming, but his item progression is such that he may as well be a support Kunkka. I don't even know. But
yeah,
but yeah, I just worry that when the BKBs come out, which is going to be very soon, about 1,000 gold for Sylan right now, and for the DK, probably, actually, not. Yeah, he a little bit more because of his deaths, I guess, unless he's got something on the courier I'm not seeing. Yeah, so it's going to be a little bit more than that. He still needs about 1,500-ish. But when those come out, like, how do you bring them down if you're Fnatic?
Well, you almost got a blink dagger on Hani, which is actually a very good timing. And he's not even putting any points in the Enchant Totem, so he's just going massive extra damage from Aftershock with with his Fissure. I think if he gets a blink, they can actually catch Empire off guard. And from a side lane, and then a Bracer. Like, that's it.
Let's see if they can kill off Always Want to Fly. That's
dear
the best.
Lord.
That's the
that's the boat we're talking about, man.
Yeah.
God, it does so much damage.
Well, and the thing is, you know, even a level 9, he's got it in 50 seconds again.
So I actually don't understand the scaling of the damage. Like, everything else is fine, but, like,
right,
400, like, it's like 400, 500, 600. Like, it's so much at level 1 compared to, the progression from 2 to 3. So, I don't know. I feel like it should be, like, 250, 350, 250, 400,
a million
points
of damage.
yeah, there you go.
That's how it feels at level 6, really. It's just like, oh, you just hit a 2-man boat, and I lost 2 heroes. That's what happened.
Yeah. It's like, Finger of Death is what, 500, a single target at level 1, which is already ridiculous, by the way. It's like the highest nuke at level 6. Now you're like, okay, let's tune that down.
Hang on,
a bit.
Excalibur. Hit by Mag, caught by the hook, cogged in, and nope. Only the mini ult, not the real thing. They're going to try to respond to this. There's going to be another X-Cord that'll catch Mag into the Mystic Flare and that boat right back off CD. Going to try to pursue them out. There's an Echo Slam to slow it down, and the Fissure going to catch them with the Doom. Bring it down, Excalibur. Good call, but not worth that. Giving up 3-for-1. And every time Fnatic just seems like they're getting a little flat, every time it looks like they might be falling too far behind, they take a big win, and I'm not sure what was going on there. There's going to be a Fissure to bail out No-Tail. But hell with it. He's probably got boat off cooldown again. Not quite. X-Torrent catches Always Want to Fly. Resolution hanging there, trying to make sure he can buy time. Here's Hani again, using that Enchant Totem, buying time. There's going to be, yes, one Concussive Shell. I'll bring him down from distance. Now they're converging on the Resolution. He has utilized his Shadow Blade, though. Do they have a gem? They do not. He ran right past the sentry, but now hooked up with by Vanscore. Vanscore is level 8. We've yet to see any real relocates yet. And well, one would think that'll end up being a factor as the game goes later. We're coming up on 20 minutes. There's a hook. Little payback now from Max. He catches Big Daddy. Boat's going to be on the way, but he is going to end up dying nonetheless. The rest of his team ends up retreating. And yeah, Boat's one of those things. I like the way it works because he couldn't just throw it right at the clockwork there. He was a little too tight in quarters.
He was just using it for the defensive capabilities.
Oh, yeah.
But yeah, he was dead regardless.
So it's going to end up being a tower brought down by Empire. And it's becoming a bit of a seesaw match for sure. However, Fnatic continues to whittle down the lead that Empire built so early in the game. And in fact, they're building a fairly decent experience lead, all things considered.
Yeah, the support play from Fnatic is actually on point. It's perfect. Like,
for sure.
Flies 4-1-6 on the Skywrath. He's where he needs to be. He's getting very good levels. Look at, he's actually 3 levels higher than the Treant, who's on the winning team, basically. I say winning, it's kind of a wash, honestly. It's 9-14.
Yeah.
But they do have more towers and, like, map control. I consider that kind of the winning team. But
well,
he's 4-1-6. Hani is 0-0-10.
Oh,
and he had a very early blink dagger up top. We saw that surprise factor coming in, and it was really, really effective. And that was with a level 1 ulti, too. So his damage output actually heavily increases with levels in the Echo Slam. So Hani's just playing fantastically.
He is, for sure. I don't think there's any doubt. If it wasn't for him, I think this match would have gone by the wayside quite some time ago. Excalibur's not playing bad, don't get me wrong, but He and Trixie are trying to really catch up in terms of net worth as the Gyro and the DK continue to maintain a fairly decent lead there. There's that BKB now done on Resolution.
Very important.
And the Gyrocopter has his as well. And both are at 10 seconds, by the way. And it wouldn't shock me at all if we don't see Empire just go ahead and try to five-man. Now, we can see they're suffocating Fnatic out and taking control of their jungle. Fnatic is hanging out as four here under their own tier two. They may smoke into their own jungle. Do they have anyone? No, actually, I think they just... Nope, there it is. And smoking now behind the tier two. They're not going to go into their own jungle. I figured they suspected that's where they would be. They're going to run right down mid and run right into Empire if they continue straight down. Now they're just going to hide in the trees for the moment, going past the Roche pit now, and see some pings and some drawing. Let's see. They're going to go ahead and check Roche and check the Ancients, it would seem. Smoke has about a quarter, not making a third of the time left. And Empire, very well aware that this is a scary moment. No one's on the map, and they are playing back and playing very defensive. And yeah, it looks like Fnatic is not going to get a whole lot out of this. So a lot of wasted time for them. If anything, though, they did force Empire back and force them to be a little bit more defensive, at least for a minute.
Yep, and here's a five-man smoke coming out of Empire looking to do something. And they should. They have their BKBs, which were very, very important items. Already a chainmail starting for Resolution, so he wants the beginnings of that AC coming out pretty shortly. Could see a wraparound here. Obviously, this wasn't spotted out.
Yep, they're going to run right into him. Let's see. Yep, there we go. Excalibur runs right into Resolution, and they're going to engage. Great engagement. There's the damage coming back out. Big Echo Slam. Mag doomed out, brought down. That's going to be one down immediately. Excalibur still up for the moment. His own BKB keeping him alive. Behind that, we're going to see another Dragontail that'll catch Hani over in the trees. Here comes Silent trying to catch up with the rest of them. Fnatic loses two in exchange for two. And yeah, that could have actually gone much worse for both teams.
Yeah.
And so I think, honestly, all things considered, I think both are going to walk away from that being like, all right, that's all right.
Yeah, it was kind of wonky. Like, they initiated, some of them initiated on the Shadow Fiend, but they didn't burst him down in time. I was actually thought he was going to die immediately because
yeah,
he did BKB before the Dragontail. But no, they didn't have enough damage. Silent was focusing on the Skywrath Mage first, I believe.
Well, they were split up.
That was
the issue. They had two over,
exactly.
over in this region. And up, hang on, speaking over in this region. X-Torrent, and there's going to be the dust. If they can get Resolution, this will be a nice pick. Boat on the mark. No, doesn't matter. They got it. Mag actually manages to cog in too. Problem is, he's there by himself now. Save your buddy syndrome strikes again. There's going to be a call down, though. A return kill on Excalibur makes this all right. They do pick off the IO as well. Silence actually going to be caught and hit with the Mystic Flare.
Oh, my God.
This is an absolutely devastating exchange for Empire. They gave up so much. Instead of just losing one hero and being done with it, they committed a ton to try to get payback and end up losing everyone but the tree. And yes, they got Excalibur, but even then, not at all worth it. Sentry goes down, and yep, always want to fly. Going to be spotted. Beautiful fissure. Sentry goes down, and he's going to make it a full five-man wipe for the second time in a row. Taking him a bit because of living armor, but down he goes.
That is really impressive stuff right there.
It is.
Like, just the presence of mind, going back there. Trixie was so low on health, but he's doing everything he can. He knows his limits. All of them know their limits, and they know exactly what they can do and get away with. Now they're going to take this tower. This is very important, too. This is the first tower of the game. They're going to get it. Hani with the extra damage after using the Enchant Totem will get that and secure that. And it looks like he's probably going to get maybe a four staff or a Yules. But wow, Fnatic has really bounced back. And in terms of net worth, of course, Gyro and the DK are still on top. But I would imagine this is actually going in favor of Fnatic now. Gold is pretty much even.
We're almost reset.
Gold's pretty much even, but look at experience. It's basically 7,500 in favor of Fnatic. And the cool thing is like, they were doing all this and winning these fights basically with just their spells. Like,
yep.
They're not, items aren't necessary except for maybe a blink on Hani. But as we approach more to the mid to late game, items on Shadowfiend are going to really start to pump out. Same thing with the Doom. So I'm actually favoring Fnatic right now.
Yeah, I think I am too. I don't know. I mean, ultra late, say 40, 50 minutes in.
I would still definitely favor Fnatic.
Really?
Yeah, they have the Doom. Doom is just so good ultra late because no matter how much farm you have on one hero, they pretty much get nullified just by an ultimate from Doom.
Yeah.
And so that means it's more effective later than sooner, actually. And it's still effective soon.
You know something we haven't seen used at all? Relocate.
Yeah.
This does not feel at all like an IO game. He honestly could be any support that has a little bit of range damage. IO gives you more than just relocate, but I mean, hell, that's what defines him. And we have yet to see that utilized at all in a meaningful way by Empire. Big Daddy engaged upon at top. Hani's there to help bail him out. There's going to be the boat. BKBs were required. And the reactions from Fnatic seem to be much more on point as this game has gotten later and later. We're just seeing them in the right position to deal with the aggression that Empire is known for and that gave them so much success in the early game. But Fnatic, I mean, they are in a dominant position right now. I mean, like you said, the gold is basically, yeah, the gold is even. Fnatic at no point has had the gold in their favor. It's right above zero, still slightly in favor of Empire, but slightly by literally less than 100. But the experience is actually into five-digit territory, so they are beginning to out-level them very, very heavily.
Imagine when Kunkka starts getting items. Like, he's got 2,500 on top of drums.
Is he ever going to get items?
Yeah, I don't know. I feel like Hani should play, like, support every game, because he's owning so hard.
Oh,
like,
he is.
Like, I know Fly's doing very well, and his numbers definitely reflect that, 8, 2, and 6. Hold that thought, though.
Oh, this is nice.
As we might see an engagement here. Yep. Always want to fly.
Yep.
It blinks out in time.
They're still going to pursue him out. There's going to be Hani with another Fissure and the Mystic Glare to secure the kill.
Look at that combo between just the Fissure and the ultimate from Skywrath. That just totally screws him up. But, like, Hani is really saving this game for Fnatic. And it's actually bouncing them back. His numbers obviously reflect, like I said, for Fly. But 0-1 and 14 for Hani doesn't do him justice. He's in the right place at the right time every single time. He knows when they engage on top. Just his presence alone. Didn't even have to cast a spell. When they used that call down to try to initiate on the no-tail, he just blinked in and just kind of sat there. And that was enough to actually get them to back up, because they know the damage output of well-placed Fissures and ultimates and all that jazz from Earthshaker. So I would say definitely right now at this point, Hani is just playing out of his mind.
Yeah, I completely agree. He has 100% kept this game manageable. And Fnatic, manageable is not the word. Like, there's no doubt in my mind. They're in the lead. And one thing that, I don't know. We've got two butterflies that are going to be on the way, by the way. Shadow Fiend has picked up his Eagle Song, as has the Gyrocopters. So the ability to bring those heroes down got to be tough.
I don't know why he's getting a butterfly on Gyro. That just doesn't make sense to me. Like, I don't think he needs the sheer right-click evasion. Hold on. I always want to fly. He's right next to his center. This one, he's blink out right now. He doesn't get it in time. And he will fall again.
Yep.
How many? He's 1-8-2. Not a great performance from Always Wanna Fly thus far.
I think teams have just figured out that if there's a Treant Protector on the map, you can expect him to be wandering around your jungle. That's one thing that, you know, some, like, I don't believe for a minute that, like, that kind of strategy, like the tree strategy, has been figured out and is solved now or something. But that particular aspect of it, just expecting that and knowing that, okay, if we invest in sentries here and there and we make sure they're just down and very, very likely walking paths, we'll probably get a few free kills. Teams have just figured that out, and that's exactly what we saw happen there. Fnatic, off that kill, takes another tier one, and they're beginning to whittle down the map control a little bit. They don't have a lot themselves, but trying to draw it back to even.
Dragon Knight, he popped the ultimate as well as his 9-second BKB to try to get himself to live and do a little bit of damage to the top tower. Or sorry, mid tower. Top tower, in the meantime, does fall in favor of Fnatic. But yeah, Always on a Fly, he's been caught out way too many times. And like I said, when you start getting some damage items finally up on the Big Daddy here, he has enough for Lothar's if he really wants it. I'm surprised he hasn't bought it yet. I think Lothar's is just so freaking good.
Think that'd be the right call?
On Kunkka. I think it's core on the hero. But oh yeah, let's talk about the butterflies. Let's purchase up and finalize here for Shadow Fiend. I feel like it's just not the item here for Gyro this game. Like, he's going to be dying to magic damage after BKB and Doom. Like, Doom is just going to screw him. Also, the cleave damage from Kunkka doesn't really care about evasion. So, actually, Aegis here goes to Shadow Fiend. They did get a Roshan relatively quickly. So, yeah, I think Fnatic is just really taking control of this game. They're looking good.
Like you said, the Rosh drops, and Fnatic continuing to build on. Yeah, they actually are, for the first time in, it took them 25 minutes or so, but they finally actually got the gold in their favor, and the experience is staying right where it was. Trixie picked up a plate mail, most likely going for a Shiva's, Hani, Force Staff, and Blink Dagger, Ultra Mobility on the Earthshaker. Excalibur did finish his Butterfly in the meantime, and that Force Staff, core item, very important item on Skywrath Mage, has already come out as well. So the item progression all of a sudden really taking a turn for the best for Fnatic. They did seem to be slowing down a bit in that regard, but last 5 to 8 minutes have really just gone so heavily in their favor. Butterfly's also done on Silent too, so don't want to act as if they're completely ahead in that regard. Net worth-wise, Excalibur is in first position now. First time that has been the case for Fnatic pretty much all game. And he's just a smidge above the Gyro, but he's caught back up. And this is actually spreading out quite a bit, as it looks like, yeah, they've got people on the low ground and the high ground, so I'm going to use a zoom out view. I'm not trying to overuse it. Usually, I just use it at Roche when they're cracking tier threes or whenever there's a smoke, but this, they've got them so spread out that I feel like I kind of got to use it. So
yeah, it actually makes sense.
Yeah, just want to explain that to the viewers.
Oh, always want to fly in trouble again.
There we go.
Gets caught out.
Yep, he's going to end up dropping. There was Mag in with the hook, but now he's trying to get out. Excalibur down to about half health, and they managed to catch Mag on the low ground. They'll probably finish him out. In the meantime, Silent got doomed and was forced to withdraw, moving back towards his own base, and Fnatic gets a couple and gets two very important ones. They're not done. That Doom's still active on the Gyro. Finally does wear off. They may be able to pursue him out. Hani shot the Fissure a little bit early, but there's only two outer tier towers remaining now for Empire. And Excalibur, oh, wow, they're actually going to reinitiate, though. Big Daddy caught, and they managed to pop the Aegis in the meantime. So they're going to be bringing the Shadow Fiend back up. They're going to lose Trixie and Big Daddy at the same time.
Oh, they didn't finish Trixie. He got away.
Oh, wow. And Excalibur. Oh, there's another great Fissure from Hani. That's going to secure the kill there. And an Echo Slam. Resolution. Able to survive at least for a moment. Makes it back under the tower. Vanscore bailing him out there for sure. But Excalibur back up off of the Aegis, the difference maker that time around. And like you said, they didn't finish Trixie. Trixie back in base quite happy to be healing back up. So he should have been dead for sure. Now we're going to have Resolution spotted by Hani. He's going to Dragon Tail and catch him straight away. We'll be able to secure one kill. Let's see if Fly's out of mana. He can't do a whole lot. Now Vanscore's there, and Fly's going to end up feeding here. No, four staffs away. In the meantime, Excalibur caught with the overgrowth on the high ground. They do track down Fly, and always want to Fly right there with... What's going on? A lot of low health heroes just walking into horrendous situations. And Empire, who looked like they had just lost a crippling fight, suddenly picks off Excalibur, as well as the Earthshaker and the Skywrath, all of whom came into situations where they had little to no health.
This is the Resolution show here for Empire. Sure. Really carrying them and keeping them back in this game. He also got a regen amidst that fight. I don't know if it was bottled or if he picked it up or if he bottled and then used it, but it also played a role in there. I didn't really exactly watch all of the movements from start to finish. Oh, actually, Trixie, is he in trouble? No, he's not. They should just get his tower safely and get back. By the way, it was a BKB that went up for Kunkka, so he's not going to go for the Lothars, at least for now. Boat comes in, too late, too tardy the party, as you say, and they will still get the tower. So Resolution, now with the Assault Crash online, 2K gold, he's starting to get that item progression back up and running. Haste Rune is now bottled for Kunkka in the face of Resolution, but yeah, he is really keeping them back in this game. Going for a crit now for the Dragon Knight.
Right now, like you said, man, it is all about Resolution. Getting crit up, getting damage up. They really are so dependent on him to just control this match.
Yeah.
Excalibur has picked up a little bit of Life Leech, getting the Helm of the Dominator up. And Silent got about 2K gold set away, and would imagine he'll be going for a big damage item now. It's about that time to start putting Flak Cannon to good use. But, I mean, looking ahead, we're now at 33 minutes in. And after that exchange, you can actually see Fnatic had built a 5K gold lead of themselves for themselves, and it had been cut down by half. Now they're going to try to catch Mag, but BKBing through it, boats off the mark. And this is the situation I was talking about, though. BKBs are coming out in force now. You've got one on Clock, one on the Dragon Knight, and one on the Gyro. Do you think they have sufficient damage on Fnatic to deal with that if Empire is able to initiate the way they want to?
I think they do. I think they definitely have the damage. Like, Skywrath is pumping out so much freaking damage, 12, 3, and 7.
Well, that's what I mean, is BKBs, though.
Like, yeah, like, well, they can wait it out. I think they can wait it out, because Fissures are kind of blocking people. They're disrupting the movements. They can use X marks the spot, I guess, when they don't have BKB. But they also have Doom. I think they have ways to wait out the BKBs. I don't think the BKB on Silent's going to really do much, because he bought it so early. He's starting to go through those charges. It's now 7 seconds. I still also question his, like, butterfly pickup. I just don't think it was the pickup here. I think he should have got something else, maybe just, extra damage. I mean, butterfly's okay, I guess, in that regard, but I just don't think you benefit from the evasion. If you don't benefit from the evasion, really, I just don't see it being a warranted pickup, but that's just my opinion. I mean, I could be totally wrong, but I like it way better, for instance, on Shadow Fiend. Like, I think it's way more effective. I don't even think it's actually that good on Shadow Fiend, but I think it's better on him than it is on Resolute or Silent in this game.
Correct me if I'm wrong. Have we seen a single real... Oh, hang on. Hold that thought. Yep, we're going to have Trixie hit with the lead sheet. There's a blink away. Playing with fire is always want to fly, and they know he's there. And he's keeping an eye on Trixie.
He's been in this area like the whole game.
Yeah.
He's died 9 times.
Yep. Teams just figure it out. You're a walking ward, and if you don't mind feeding here and there, then yes, you could do this very efficiently. But anyway, is it just me, or did I miss it? Has there been a single relocate this game?
Oh, God. I think there was one.
I must have missed it completely because I do not remember it. Like, and it's pretty tough to miss. So I don't know. Maybe I was just being bad at my job and completely.
They don't really have. Okay, Wisp. I mean, you mentioned how he's known really for his relocates, and that's kind of what defines a hero. And I agree, but I think in this metagame, he's more important for the overcharge. Like, I feel like that's the hero in my eyes. The overcharge just buffs up one hero, makes them like unkillable, really makes it hard to even burst down. Actually, Wisp himself sometimes, and that's what it's going to be used for this game. Again, always want to fly. Do they have a gem on someone, or he's just almost going to die? Always want to fly.
Yeah, a little late on the sentry placement that time. So always want to fly has learned he has got to be quick on the blink trigger if he reveals the smoke. Otherwise, he is going to be killed off. But let you know, just as an example, and you know, all right, so. Trixie in kind of a precarious situation. They've got resolution here. And I want to see... Okay, I was curious if they were, like, trying to do something really, really cheeky. But once again, they're coming in from the south. Here's Always Want to Fly. Moving back in. And going to walk right up on Trixie. They see him this time. And using the Shivas. Does he have a gem? I don't know if anyone does. Doesn't look like he does. Mag. They're with him and pulling back. But okay. Now it looks like there's not going to be a fight. We saw... Treant, you know, Leech Seed, and then Trixie walked right here and just started farming, right? There was an IO and a gyrocopter completely by themselves in their own jungle. Why not a relocate there? Is it just too risky, or...
Well, they don't have vision. They don't see, and there were no members of Fnatic showing on the map, really. Like, maybe one in mid for a second, but that's too close to Trixie to really burst him down. And Trixie's very tanky. Like, look at him. BKB is really good against relocate, too, because you can obviously see it coming. It gives you ample time to get ready to pop that. Not to mention, even if he didn't have BKB, he's got Vlads for extra armor, face boots for extra movement speed with the drums, and a Shiver's guard as well. So, he's very, very tanky. Four staff up onto, as far as more items go, four staff onto Clockwork. And was that a Satanic? Yeah, yep. Satanic for...
You'll say speed.
I'm not a fan. I feel like Daedalus is so good on Shadow Fiend. I think... Going the offensive route actually helps you defensively because it makes the other team more scared of you, and they have to change their play a bit. There's a gem I think that was desperately needed for Fnatic. They should not be wasting. They're actually going to save money if they bought it earlier on all these sentries they've been posting in their woods. There's another one actually to the side of him, but a gem coming on the courier now.
Looks like Fnatic ready to push a bit. It has been a bit of an extended period of largely passive play from both teams. And here's going to be a smoke out of Empire. They're moving down, entering the Radiant Jungle. They've got Resolution down near this tower. That tower is in deny range. We'll see if Resolution is going to try to actually deny it. Coming out late, and here we go. There's going to be the hook. They're going to catch Big Daddy, and Resolution reveals himself as well. Excalibur doing what damage he can. That's a lot. There's going to be an overgrowth. Here's the boat. Doesn't catch anything. Trixie doing what he can as well. Silent, though, pecking away at Excalibur for the moment. There's going to be a Mystic Flare that ends up picking off Resolution behind all of this. Banscore now hemmed in. He's going to end up dying inside of the trees as well. And no, actually, he does manage to make it away. And the rest of Empire pulling back. Looks like Kunkka secures a kill. No, he did get Banscore at the end of it. So Banscore unable to make it to safety. Hani wound up for the Fissure. Will go ahead and throw it. Mag right there. Shiva's going to slow him down. And Silent trying to ward him away. He will be able to TP back home. Silent now being pursued all the way past his tier 2 and up to the tier 3. And Fnatic ready to go ahead and take another one as the tier 2 should be dropping relatively quickly. The right click has built pretty well. There's going to be an MKB out now on the gyrocopter, and very cute play here, by the way. X marksing himself just to fill his bottle and coming back after a TP.
It's actually really useful.
Oh, it's huge.
You can literally just heal yourself to full from basically nothing.
Yep.
Using the bottle, because the length of time is what, like 8 seconds now?
Yeah
it's a ton. You can constantly just spam bottle and base. It constantly regens you once you get back for a couple seconds too. So, and then Roshan now with a dire advantage. I don't know. Fnatic's so weird, man. Like, they're playing so well right now. And I really think the biggest issue was, like, they're drafting for a long time. They would draft some weird-ass shit. Like, really weird heroes and lanes that just didn't make any sense. So they still do that from time to time. But when they get more quote-unquote standard heroes and standard lanes and things that are just logical and make more sense and they're weird. Honestly, even this game was not even that standard because they had the Kunkka tri-lane with the... You know, with Hani roaming around with Behemoth, but after they get out of the laning stage, they're good players and they're smart. If they can break past that laning phase, then it really just shows, you know, how good they are. So
I think a lot of times Fnatic runs a bend but don't break style. Like this, you know, basically I think they, it feels to me like they approach the game going, okay, we want to have X potential at X moment in this game. How can we get that? And they draft for that, and then they just let the lanes work themselves out. And they say, okay, maybe our laning phase will be a little troublesome, but it's not going to matter because we're going to execute. Hang on, Big Daddy. Forced to BKB. I could never get used to calling No-Tail Big Daddy. It's just a caster habit to read the names.
Yeah, exactly.
There's going to be a Doom behind that, and Silent. It's all good trap.
Blocked by his own cogs. There comes the relocate out. Nicely played there by Wisp.
Yep. The cogs, like you said, blocking his own man. And Fnatic, can't even see where they're going,
what
actually.
What the hell?
Yeah, I'm curious, too. Mag now moving in and suiciding, for lack of a better word. Here comes Silent back up, though. The damage just isn't there. Excalibur is huge and has a Satanic. I was going to say, why is he running? He can go toe-to-toe. Resolution is back up, and here comes Hani as well. Trixie being pecked away. Excalibur doing what damage he can. He's going to end up having the Aegis pop, but they managed to get Resolution once again. And here he comes right back up. He's ready to go ahead and try to engage. And Silent coming back. The X marks the spots are just making these fights so crazy. Vanscorn next on the list. If they get him, it'll be a full fiver. Down he goes. And that might just about be the turning point. That's going to make it feel very hard to reach now if you're Empire.
I don't know how Empire wins this game.
I don't either.
Excalibur is unkillable with this build he went with, the Satanic plus Butterfly. Like, I saw the engagement bottom. Like, he didn't even need the Satanic down there. He was just, like, going toe-to-toe with Gyro, and he just, like, missed every attack.
Yep.
And it actually was really useful in that sense. Starcopter buys back, but no one else is really ready to fight. DK has no gold. He just bought a Daedalus. He's got no buyout for 30 seconds. Here comes an ulti.
Yep. Good overgrowth. Paul's going to be there. Trixie doing what damage he can, but being pecked away, finally they bring him down. But Excalibur going toe-to-toe, and here comes that boat. Boat doesn't catch anything, but the ROM soaks them and gives him a little more time. Mag being pecked away at by Excalibur. Always want to fly, shows himself. And using that lead sheet, they're just trying to delay, but delaying the inevitable is the best I think they can hope for at this stage. Yep, there's going to be an X torrent on the Always Want to Fly. And down he goes. Fnatic just rolling over them now at this point. And the Rax going to end up going down shortly. DK is back up. They're only going to take one and then try to get out. Yep, he catches them with a Dragon Tail, so if they can get the kill here, there's going to be a Doom on a Resolution, though. They do manage to pick up Excalibur. There's a Fissure, but Resolution continuing to survive through it. He's going to be X'd and brought back here in just a minute. And once again, Mag using that point-blank hook. We're going to see Hani make it away just by the skin of his teeth. Mag's going to end up dead to a level death. Big Daddy caught with another Dragon Tail. And the right-click enough to punish him for hanging around a little too much. Hani, using that Ghost Scepter, got away. Could not have been with more than 50 HP. But as the dust settles, they get the Tier 3, they get the Melee Racks, and they extend their lead. Now the biggest of the game. 10,000 gold lead for Fnatic, 15,000 experience.
Yeah, I believe that boat, that Kunkka's rum, actually saved Hani there. It was really, really freaking close. I would say even like less than 20 HP is what he had. But, yeah, I mean, Excalibur died, but he got the Rex. All right, mission accomplished. So, things are good for them. He had another item coming out. Oh, yeah. Sorry, full MKB, by the way, for Shadow Fiend. So, that butterfly that was already a weird pickup is now useless.
Yep.
He also bought an MKB, actually, himself on Gyro. I missed that.
Yep.
So.
Yeah, he finished that not long ago, a few minutes ago.
Yeah, so, I mean, that's a good pickup. I like that. But this Shadow Fiend is just too much of a problem, I feel. For Empire. Like, Mag haven't really felt his real effectiveness this game. Didn't do too well in the laning phase and wasn't able to be that active early on. As a result, it's kind of not really working out for them in the mid to late game now. And Always Want to Fly, he's just died way too many times in the early to mid game as well.
Oh, yeah.
With 1-11-4 as his kill count. Resolution, he actually has done very well this game, but it's just not enough. He can't solo carry this team with DK in this instance, so... Got good items and now has, I believe, enough gold for buyback. I think that was the biggest thing, is that he just bought his Daedalus last time. Didn't have the buyback. Let me just double check to make sure he has it. He does have it, yeah. Or he does have it. He does have it. It's early, man. Shit.
Isn't it? Oh, my God. But early, but yeah. We do it for you. We love you guys.
Exactly.
And we love Dota. And we're just going to talk in very dulcet tones like we're on National Public
Radio. Ah, yes.
See, this is what happens whenever you have casters here. Both sleepy, haven't eaten, and
I know.
Our blood sugar's plummeting, and there's not a lot of action at the moment. But in fairness, action or not, Fnatic is completely in control and ready to perhaps put the nail in the coffin as they march down bottom lane now. They're going to try Empire. By they, I mean Empire. Looks like they want to try to stunt this by split pushing themselves. We'll probably send one back. We'll be Honey. No, that's five. I mean, they got to decide. The push power of Empire is nothing to sneeze at. There's going to be a boat and the torrents there. They got, no, he BKB through it. Excalibur BKBs as well as he activated a Satanic. Hasn't had to. Just standing there and using that life leech to tank through everything. And this just goes to show you. I mean, Empire cannot fight. Beautiful Fissure.
Oh, yeah.
Only caught, always want to fly, though. They certainly would have, at this stage of the game, liked to catch a more valuable hero. Trixie, BKBs, and Excalibur actually caught with a Dragon Tail and brought down. Mag with a BKB of his own. Trixie's trapped in as well. And this is a big turnaround. There was a buyback out of Excalibur. Trixie down for 100 seconds. Now Resolution.
Dear
caught
Lord.
With a Fissure and another Mystic Flare. That combination. Absolutely devastating. Fnatic has made it work for themselves all game long. And now Empire back on the run. But, you know, chasing a Clockwork is always a risky proposition. He can turn a pursuit around so quickly and punish you for being greedy and wanting to rout them. But looks like we are going to have the battle separate, at least for a moment. But Empire's not giving up. Nope, there we go. He hooks into the creeps, actually. Manages to catch Excalibur. Makes his way up, but there's going to be the boat. And Silent, this is probably not a battle he can win. Satanic has been activated and able to finally start going to work. Mag has to back up. Silent has to try. Oh, beautiful Fissure again. Hani has been on point. Big Daddy. Yep. Didn't even need the right click. They're going to get Vanscore from behind as well, slowly but surely. And Excalibur doing the right click they need. And Hani has been playing like his hair is on fire. The man has been everywhere, has done everything right, and really has been the standout player of this entire game. 4-3-23. He's been involved in 27 of Fnatic's kills and has really been the biggest difference maker, not just in this game, not just in this series, but honestly so far, thus in the playoffs as a whole.
Yeah, I couldn't agree more. And just the interaction between him and Skywrath is
huge.
Insane. Like, you saw that. DK just dropped. Like, when he doesn't have BKB up, DK is actually really useless. Just because of the massive magical damage output.
LOL. Oh,
always want to fly. Dies before the boat even gets there. My God, look at that Mystic Flare. And that Mystic Flare is like, what, 20 second cooldown?
Yeah.
Yeah, he doesn't even really need a Scepter. He went Bloodstone, by the way, and he has 9 charges, so he's going to regen his mana quickly, and he needs all of it. So, yeah, the damage output is so high from spells for Fnatic. And because DK got a BKB relatively early on, it's 4 seconds. So he cannot rely on that in fights. This is another set of racks for Fnatic, by the way. I don't know how Empire jumps back into this. With BKB duration being way too low on resolution, I feel like he has to rebuy it. Like, he absolutely needs a new 10-second BKB.
Oh, yeah.
He can't fight in these fights with a 4-second BKB. It's just too low of a duration.
Honestly, this is one of those games where, especially at this stage, you just turtle, and it's time for the Hail Mary Rapier. That's the one nice thing. A gyro.
Is he going for it, or does he have it?
I don't know.
No, I would agree with you. He needs it.
That's literally, like, that's just what you do. Like,
yeah.
If you get behind in this situation, one of the benefits of a gyro, and he has his strengths and his weaknesses, but one of the bigger ones is you can find yourself in this terrible situation. You can turtle like hell, and then just go for a Hail Mary Rapier and hope that things work out. And sometimes it does. And but honestly, at this point, the play of Fnatic is so good.
This Roche is so important. I feel like they have to contest this. I think Clockwork is going to go in.
Here
they cannot
get
another Roche.
Always want to fly. Gets an overgrowth up behind that. The battle engages. Hani force staffing out. Boat's there. Now caught on. They're way funneled in. No Tail doing what he can. Resolution has been doomed behind that. Just kind of a scattering of heroes. Now we're going to have a Mystic Flare onto Resolution. He's chasing down Fly. In the meantime, we see the Aegis was snatched by Tree. He lost it as soon as he got it. Now Excalibur's going to ult basically no one and uses, finally, the ability to regen back up. And just heard an Echo Slam go off somewhere. Rest of the battle does rage, but Fnatic re-engages as a team, manages to bring down the Gyrocopter. Vanscore next to eat it, and behind that, we actually see Hani still trying to chase down Mag. I heard him Echo Slam, didn't see what actually happened. But at the end of the day, ends up being 3-0. They did snatch the Aegis, but honestly, I don't think Fnatic's going to care. Buyback status, they don't have it on Excalibur, but they have it on most of the heroes they need. And more importantly, when you look at Empire, DK does have it. Gyro's actually, yep, gonna have to spend it as well. So whatever hope they had for big time item progression to save them is beginning to fall off. There's a buyback from DK, and just look how quickly they're chipping away at these tier fours. There's gonna be a hook though, got two! Hani's right there to help out, here comes the boat. Trixie doing what he can, Mag caught in there as well as anyone. Silent doing what damage he can behind that. We see Resolution chasing a Ghost Sceptered Skywrath Mage and dying because of it. And now they're gonna re-engage. Mag forced the BKB, there's gonna be an X on Always Wanna Fly, never had a chance.
Three shot.
Yep. And that should be that. DK, 100 seconds. Is he
trapped? Oh, nice block!
No, he forced that through it. Okay. Nice shot, though, from Hani. Nonetheless, it's irrelevant. GG. So Fnatic, who has taken the longer path thus far, had to come through our quarterfinals to meet Empire, who earned a bye straight into the semifinals as a number two seed out of the group stage. And looks like, yeah, they're actually going to continue to fight this. They called GG, I saw it. I'm not out of my mind. And Fnatic, yeah, just gonna, there it is. But Fnatic, who came through as one of the lower seeds out of the group stage, meeting Empire, who got the bye, was a top two seed, and drops game one. Fnatic's wonky lanes working out in the end, and Excalibur once again, the stand in, stand out, continues to perform and continues to help lend Fnatic a lot of success. 51 minutes it took them. Where did things go wrong, my friend? Where did things really get crooked for Empire? Because they had a lead and seemed like they were going to just roll that game up at one point.
There was one fight that I forget, but what comes to mind to me really was honestly when Silent was like trying to go past that tier two by himself with the Wisp. It was just a Wisp, and they were like, he was way past that tier two tower up top, and he had no reason to being there. I don't think that like really sealed the deal for them, but it was plays like that that showed you, like, we are actually not as strong as we think we are.
Right.
And that just little pickoffs like that is what let Fnatic get back in the game, and little pickoffs like that is what got the early blink dagger for Hani, honestly.
Yep.
And I think that's what really kind of set the tone for the rest of the game, is once Hani started getting, easier pickoffs with that blink, it just started a snowball for him.
Yep.
Him and, I mean, goddamn, look at his fly is.
I know.
18, that, 4, and 18.
That is like the quietest 18 kills I've ever seen. Like, he was always there. His item progression was okay. I mean, it wasn't fantastic. But yeah, by the time all said and done, he had piled up 18 freaking kills, man.
Yeah, it actually worked out so well for him because the game drawn out to 51 minutes, it felt so much shorter for some reason. Usually it's the other way around. But because it draw was so long, these BKB charges were so little duration that he just owned them. Like, four seconds is nothing in a team fight of 50 minutes, especially against the Skywrath Mage, against Hani, who has massive damage with Echo Slam, yada, yada, yada. So, yeah, Fly and Hani. I wonder, is this just Hani being so good at Earthshaker, or is this real play support? Because, like, I feel like he knows how to roam the map. And that's not to say he doesn't play mid well, because he does. I honestly feel like his support is better. Like, we look at, for instance, like, Aoi, for example.
Right.
It's not that really his carry was that bad, but his support is just better.
That good.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. No, I totally agree. And, you know, I've been watching Hani in Dota 2. I've been watching all these guys, except for, obviously, Excalibur. The very first tournament Fnatic entered, whenever they were finally making the switch full-time to Dota 2, was the original season of D2L. So I've literally been watching these guys from the moment they entered Dota 2 and watched them develop. Hani, like you said, he's great in mid, but I agree. I am just, and you know, there's only so much you can sample from this. Maybe it's just he's really good at the hero. Maybe it's just a really good stretch for them.
Like I said,
but
realistically,
based on what I think we've seen over the last few days, he is so good playing from the four and the five, playing the, you know, playing the get stuff done support, playing heroes like the Earthshakers. So I don't know. All I know is that this lineup with Excalibur is certainly working for Fnatic, and they're now one win away from fighting their way through not just the group stage, but through our playoff bracket and into the upper bracket finals. They lead against Empire now 1-0. I'm your host here in AC Chambers. On the side of me, that's Trouf. We're here live from the mothership, HyperX's Fountain Valley headquarters here, right around the LA Irvine area. Thanks for tuning in, everyone. This is our first best of three of the day. We'll have Rock's Kiss taking on Na'Vi in the second best of three, but for now, at least one more game, too, if Empire gets their way and is able to force it to a game three. Stick with us. We'll be right back here on the HyperX D2L Western Challenge Playoffs.